Hey, I'm Gabby Wilson for MTV News. We're coming to you live from the Soho Grand Hotel with Nick Jonas, Ben Schnetzer, Brad Land, and Andrew Neil to talk about their new movie, Goat. What's up, guys?
What's up?
How are you?
I'm good. So, Nick, you just had a birthday recently. How did you celebrate, and was it anything like any of your research for this film?
No, my research for this film was really rough night in Bowling Green, Ohio.
Yeah, I've heard about that.
You have?
Well, I've heard you talk about, mention it, but not get into any specifics.
Well, my birthday wasn't quite like that. I had a show on my actual birthday night in Phoenix, and then the next night was the last show of the tour, as well as kind of the end of tour party birthday thing, so I celebrated there. And then I had yesterday to watch football and recover, so I'm all good now.
Nice.
Sounds a little bit like my college experience, too.
Yeah, solid.
Except the tour.
Yeah, well, that whole thing.
Well, you two weren't in Frats growing up, and I feel like neither were you, right, Andrew?
No.
So how was Brad a resource for creating that, like, authentic frat experience?
Today was the first time that I saw him after making the film, and I only saw you once while we were making it. In the middle, you stopped by, and we talked on the phone sometimes, but really, I mean, the primary resource was his book. Mm. You know, we really worked off that the most.
For
and
sure.
It's sort of an emotional moment because here he is in the flesh for all of us, and it's kind of cool.
Brad, you've seen it, I'm sure.
I watched it last night.
Last night?
I did.
Any gut reactions?
My gut reactions are that I was a bit traumatized by it again. It was an amazing immersion into this thing that I made, and these guys really made this beautiful translation of it, and it was humbling and flattering and very emotional, see so many people work so hard and make something really beautiful. I think it's really beautiful. Andrew is an amazing director, and Ben and Nick inhabited these roles like nothing I ever could have imagined, when I started writing this thing when I was in graduate school. Just for it to be a movie, period, is something I never imagined. But to have this quality of actors and directors
taking on your art,
and Ethan and cinematographers, and it's just amazing. So humble and thankful, and I was like, oh, Ben, don't do that.
What about you guys? Were you guys able to use Brad as a resource in creating your character?
Yeah. I think Andrew said, the memoir itself was such an invaluable resource as far as just filling in, just breathing, life into the world of the script. And, it can be kind of a tricky dance marrying your homework and your prep work with what you do on the day. There's nothing that can really prep you for showing up and just being there with the other actors and seeing what they're bringing to it and seeing what Andrew's bringing to it. So you want to try and fill in, the world that you're coming from as much as you can without marrying yourself to any, prescriptive choices as an actor. Mm-hmm. But being able to reference Brad's book and it was just a great sounding board. It just layers, textures. Yeah, it was great.
When you're dealing with real life material, I think there's some level of responsibility to bring that to life with a certain amount of reverence.
The movie, on top of being about college fraternities, is about the relationship between you two as brothers. You have real life brothers. Did you call upon each other's brothers for any research?
I think having brothers helps a lot, because it gives you an idea of what that dynamic looks like. And you take something from everything in your own life, and I think, use it in some way. But we had lots of conversations about our relationship with our brothers. And then we had a very limited amount of time to get to know each other and build this bond. So most days after we'd shoot a scene, we'd be back at the hotel, sitting, having a smoke, talking, and just getting to know each other more. And I think those moments, those are the layers and the life that you show in just brief seconds in a film that I think really give it the depth that we hope it has. And coming from brothers was a nice thing.
Mm. Hopefully you weren't running scenes without me.
No, only me and Gus did that. Don't worry.
Yeah, he'd get really salty about that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He was very protective over us spending too much time together, but then he would encourage us to do it as well.
No, so I mean, I wanted them to spend time together, like, socially, but when they run scenes without me there, because...
Which we never did.
No.
We never did.
I don't know about that.
No, we really didn't.
You didn't? Okay.
We really didn't. Yeah.
No, because they can start to...
What's the psychology behind that?
Well, they can start to make deals with one another. They can, and it's very dangerous in terms of acting, I think, because they can lose a freshness with one another because they've done it so much, and they talk to each other about the choices they've made, and that's problematic. So yeah, tut tut if you did. If you didn't, okay.
If you did, just let me know off camera. It's fine. I've seen that you guys describe the world that you tried to create as an art frat, and I wanted to know a little bit more about like what that means.
Maybe being on set making the movie was kind of like an art frat.
Yeah. Not the actual frat in the movie.
Do you mean like we're engaging in a creative process in order to create the illusion of this fraternity, and when you do that, you as an actor and a director, immerse yourself in the psychology of the people that are involved and what they're going through. So I think. It's a bit of a journey up the proverbial river towards the heart of darkness, and I think we all experience that to some extent. It's this kind of more violent creative process that's both exciting and a little scary, maybe in its own way psychologically.
And you guys use like locally cast people too as well. Were any of them like involved in
a lot of of the guys that were in that were the brothers in the frat had been in frats. They knew about frat culture. I mean, I think in Ohio there's a lot of fraternities. I think they were just generally more familiar with fraternity life as opposed to these guys, who really basically I think you guys knew very little about what frats were all about. So I was dealing mainly with a bunch of theater nerds who I had to corral. That's also what's fun about it is I think as actors you guys get to find out about something you know very little about.
That's cool.
It's probably really important for the film too. I just think that was a really smart choice by Andrew,
important. You mean casting locally?
Keeping these guys, not coming from that world, and not bringing any kind of baggage to it or preconceptions. I think that allowed for the performances they gave, which are mind blowing. They are to me.
High praise from the man who wrote the book.
Yeah.
And lived it. Yeah. Well, Nick, you may not have like real life frat experience, but this is like your second frat bro role, right? In what ways are they different? In what ways are they similar?
Scream Queens and Goat are very different.
Yeah.
One's very colorful and
campy.
Yeah, I guess you could say that, yeah.
I don't think Goat's too campy.
But both are fun, and kind of to have, both of those projects within the same year was sort of a bizarre thing. But great, and I hope I can continue to do things like that as an actor where I do something like this that really challenges my thinking and hopefully the audience's thinking, and then things that are entertaining and cinematic and interesting for a whole different reason, and funny even.
Yeah.
I think I'm funny at times.
You are.
Thanks. I try.
For sure. In what ways do you think that this film is important with regards to like fraternity culture?
Well, we had chatted earlier about how this is it's the only film I can think of that is set against the backdrop of a fraternity that's not a comedy. Mm-hmm. I feel like every other film that takes place in a frat is a comedy. And there's a lot of fun and humor that you can mine out of that setting, but there's also a lot of difficulty that can also be mined from that. And so, you know, I hope the film is a conversation starter about masculinity. I don't think the film in and of itself is an indictment of fraternities. It's one man's experience.
Were there any like particularly difficult scenes for you guys to film?
Like every scene in the movie. Yeah.
There's not one standout. It's just
no,
like
there
a
are a few standouts. You know, different scenes were particularly demanding for like different reasons. There was a scene that Nick and I shot toward the end of the film where we're sitting in a car together. And we shot that the first week of filming. And it's one of the last scenes in the film. And it was demanding, but it was also, it felt, I have very strong memories from that day of filming. It was just a really lovely experience.
Well, to get through it so early was nice because I was really concerned. I mean, it was one of the most important scenes in the movie, and it was, you know, near the end of the narrative. So to shoot it out of order like that, I protested a lot with the production team because I really didn't want to try to do that before we'd really gotten into a lot of stuff in the movie. So I asked them to do a lot on that day, and they did a great job, but I think it's always scary to hop into a huge scene like that so early in the shooting.
And it was also, I remember we, because Nick and I had gotten out to Ohio about 4 or 5 days before we started shooting and before the rest of the cast arrived. And so we'd gotten to know each other pretty well, as well as you can within that amount of time before we started shooting. And the first scene we shot, Can I like talk about what happens in the movie here? Or do we not want to give stuff away?
I mean, you can talk about stuff, yeah.
the first scene we shot is it's the first time Nick sees me after a particularly difficult event has taken place. And I said to Andrew, I don't want to speak to Nick, I don't want to see him in the morning. I want the first time we speak to each other to be when the camera's rolling. Mm-hmm. And Andrew had relayed that message to Nick, and we shared a car together on the way to set. We both got in, we kind of both had a hat on or hoods on or whatever. We both sat in the car next to each other. We kind of just gave each other one of those, and that was it. And that was for me like, I mean, I knew it was gonna be a really special experience, but I think at that moment I was like, oh, we're on the same, like, we know what we're doing. Like, we're both bringing the same thing to this. We knew it was a short shoot. There's no time to really, faff around or apologize for, you know, how you need to do your work. And so we kind of hit the ground running, I felt.
Well, I know the story like takes place and is set in the early 2000s, but in what ways is it very relevant and important in 2016?
Well, actually, we updated it. So you'll notice the use of the iPhone and stuff. Now, originally that was a Polaroid. You were taking Polaroids of yourself, so and we turned that into an iPhone and tried to make it, contemporary.
iPhones are very popular these days.
That's the way that it's relevant to 2016.
No, I just said iPhones are very popular.
Those things called iPhones are popular these days.
Like
So.
How do you explain that hemp necklace then?
Oh, don't you love that though?
I mean,
I took that straight out of Frat House by Todd Phillips.
He was so mad that
I know. He was so good about having to wear that thing.
Oh, that's funny.
All right, so the iPhone, that's what makes this.
Yeah,
story.
No, I mean, I don't know. We the clothes were contemporary. I mean, I muted a lot of the colors because I feel like most college films are just like too colorful. Like everything looks like they just put it on and they just bought it. And so I tried to like distress everything.
But I think we've all spoken about, you know, the relevance this has right now. I mean, all you have to do is go on Twitter and search any college, major college, and there's a number of complicated situations.
Yeah. Yes.
And, you know, young adult life is already complicated. When you add some of these elements to it, it brings a whole other layer. So, you know, whether it's early 2000s or 2016, I think this is the kind of film that should be watched by people that are about to have a college experience or take it out of that, even sports teams and other things. Mm-hmm. This is within the culture and something that we all hope it's an educational tool in some sense.
And to that point, you know, I mean, part of the thing that's kind of staggering about hazing is that it hasn't changed since, exactly. You know, he went through this in the late 90s, and,
yes.
and really it hasn't changed, I don't know how many hundreds of years. We're at a particular moment where maybe, you know, as a country we're examining our own social mores, and I think in that way, you know, it's particularly relevant in this moment, hopefully, but the fact that it's been going on for so long and no one's really talked about it is kind of amazing. And actually, I remember when I started making it, I was like, oh, I'm lucky that I get to be, you know, someone who gets to kind of bring this out into the world.
To have that conversation.
To discuss. Because I remember just being surprised when after I finished the script, I was like, there must be something that, you know, you know, a fictional film that's really, you know, dived into this stuff, and there wasn't really. Mm-hmm. Obviously, there was documentaries like
right.
Frat House, but and even then,
everything
there was only that one
like
talk.
Animal House.
Yeah,
cool.
I mean, for him to get access to the fraternities, he had to pledge himself.
Right.
You know, Todd Phillips had to pledge as a fraternity, you know, brother, and so, I mean, even that is demonstrative of the fact that, you know, it's an incredibly closed culture that doesn't
Absolutely.
Want the world to see.
What goes on
behind closed doors.
It looks like it's going to be great. I'm excited for the premiere. Thank you guys all for speaking to
Thank
me today.
You.
Thanks
Thank
so
you.
Much.
Thank
Have
you.
A good day.
Thanks very much.
Bye.